previously on Fragile Fate.
I am playing Rob Carmichael. He's a private investigator in Chicago.
I'm Anita Longerman, his plucky assistant slash sidekick. I have an idea on June.
Ooh, fantastic.
She's a ghoul.
Not fantastic.
And there's a new fang around town.
It's all happened around Bootylicious, isn't it?
It really is.
Awesome. Want to head down there tonight?
Are you asking me out?
Every single night. All right, so the time is now about 6 o'clock. There's still just a little trickle of daylight. So, is there any place you wanted to hit up before heading downtown to where the Bootylicious and other locales are at? I think now would probably be a good time to grab some holy water. And I'm guessing
you swing by the Catholic church.
Yeah, I'm assuming he probably has a crucifix of some kind to wear.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, you got that ready.
Yep.
You pull up to the side of the big old cathedral church.
Mm-hmm.
And as per the agreement, Anita walks in.
Mm-hmm.
And a couple minutes later, here's some vials of holy water to come with her.
Fantastic.
I always get the wine on my cheek. Hi!
Hello.
I got the vials.
Excellent. Thank you. Here's one for you.
Thanks.
One for me.
I drink half of it.
Yeah.
I mean, it's going to burn. It's in the bloodstream. It's going to burn them. They try to bite me. So.
Okay. Do you got a cult by chance?
No. No.
There we go. That explains it.
Not a little bit. I saw it in a movie, and that's just what I'm sticking with.
Okay, there we go.
I do not drink mine.
No,
I just,
wise.
Yep, I just...
Because you do have a cult knowledge.
Yes, I do.
And you're not sharing it with your close friend. I tell you,
my God. I have explained it to her couple of times. I'm sure I have.
Apparently not, because I'm not some dip...
I really don't know why you do that. Every time.
I saw it in a movie.
It doesn't work that way.
Seriously?
No!
Right, I'm going to go get more holy water.
Good!
And after second round, there you go. I got with some more holy water.
Okay.
You're just having tea with the bishop, all right?
Oh, yes. He's a very good friend of mine.
Exactly. Dirty-minded people, you.
I am not a hooker, thank you.
Yeah, that's gross.
That is not on this sheet. Okay, it specifically says not a hooker on here.
Where?
You just wrote it in. I don't know if that counts.
Right there.
It's right there.
Right there. I can see it now.
Right there. Termus escort.
After getting equipped with the holy water and the cross, I assume you have your standard issue sidearm?
Yes.
Yep.
Yep, I have...
Derringer.
Yep, you got the derringer there.
Yep.
Okay.
It's a perfect. Weapon.
Away you go to...
You want to grab dinner first?
Sure.
Okay.
Let's do that.
Roll your drive check.
Oh.
Drive plus dex.
Are you driving?
Are you a better driver than zero?
I have two.
Fantastic. Let's have you drive there.
I was going to say, I'm the one who's got the Corvette, so.
I was going to say, there's an arrangement here. I know there is. Let's just make the drive check happen and see who's driving what way.
Yeah.
Oh, God help us.
Yeah, just plus dex.
Oh, plus dex. Oh, goody. So we're at six. Wait.
Eight.
I can't do that today. I have eight.
So another important thing to know about Buffy the Vampire Slayer. It only uses a D10 because you have two stats and a roll to augment whatever action you're trying to do.
I rolled a two. It did not go well.
Rolling a two does not go well, but it does not mean necessarily automatic failure. In fact, on that little DM sheet I have right here, it gives me the success levels table. A 9 to a 10 is a success level of 1 and adequate.
I'm going to use one of my luck points to make that a 9, then.
Your drama point?
No, luck points.
Oh, you...
I have good luck.
Oh!
Using a luck point to increase it by 1?
Yes.
Guess what? You didn't run into anything with your nice Corvette. Mind you, you ground the gears a little bit.
I was never supposed to have a manual. I'm good at many sticks, just not the shift.
And away you go.
All right.
You arrive at the scene.
Holy water, check. Gun. Something over the top of the gun. Check. Crucifix. Yep.
I'm ready.
Okay.
All right, let's...
Do you need help getting in? This is a club.
I mean, I might.
Okay.
We are looking at a small line. It's, you know, early on a Monday, so it's only about a half a block worth of line that you'd wait for. So you could hold the spot while you try to find a parking. It might be a while.
Yeah, that's probably smart.
Possibly.
Yeah.
So do you guys want to try and immediately get into the club with the line, or are you just going to stand awkward virgin on the sidewalk until she comes back?
Yeah, that one. Yeah, that one.
And after you successfully park, which I'm not going to make you roll for, I'm not cruel.
I engage the parking brake, because I feel like that's going to bite me in the backside if I don't.
That's all right. And that's good. That's a very good move.
Smart.
Here we are in front of the Bootylicious.
Mm-hmm.
It is pulsing red neon tackiness. You see a cocktail neon thing in the bar with an olive that flickers back and forth and back and forth as an arm kind of waves back and forth, showing a woman who's blonde, laughing, having a gay old time, and it says, "You only live if you try."
Yeah, yeah. They tried real hard on this one.
Yeah.
Yeah, but the girls are nice.
Yeah. Oh, that's good.
Yeah. I can introduce you if you want.
You know, if we run into any of them tonight, sure.
Oh, cool.
Yep.
A lot of old friends. So now, I know this isn't exactly your scene.
Nope.
So try not to have the flop sweats.
I will do my best.
Follow my lead.
Sounds good.
Good. So I grab you by the arm. Yep. Link.
Gotcha.
All right, so you walk across the street and get toward the line?
Yes, because I'm trying to get noticed, but not so noticed that they think I'm trying to cut.
Okay. You roll that intelligence and influence once more. Plus two, because you're putting on a show.
Thank you.
And you've got a good prop.
I'm just going to write that down. 22.
Bouncer goes, "Hey."
Hello.
Hey.
You guys part of the VIP list?
I might be.
Takes a glance. Takes a look at you. Looks at you. Name?
Anita Longerman.
So you got alias is what you're telling me. Okay.
No.
Tell you what, $50, you're in. Have fun, guys.
Thank you.
You too, Sugar.
You see flowing red carpet going across the entire floor. That nice, velvety, plush carpet. And you go, that's got to be a terrible burden to clean.
Mm-hmm.
I was thinking more of the rug burns, poor women.
Mm-hmm.
The wraparound kind of, it's not sectional, but it's a built-in piece of furniture where a couch just curves around like a booth. Mm-hmm. But there's very few tables.
Right.
The few that are there are kind of small, portable, movable.
Right.
And you can see, like, just a chain of people already starting to sit in their own little alcoves around this edge.
Right.
There's also a bar where there's a man cleaning a glass.
Gotcha. You pick us out a good spot. I'll pick us up a couple drinks. Blend in. Start looking.
Okay.
What would you like?
Gin, tonic, lemon.
Awesome. I go up to the bar.
I go check and see who's working.
Okay. What you buying?
Gin and tonic with lemon and a vodka sour.
All right. He starts pouring into the glass that he's been cleaning and spitting it in and breathing it into.
Awesome.
All right.
Is that the vodka sour?
Yeah.
Fantastic. Yeah.
Straight whiskey.
That'll be the next one.
That would be funny as heck, because then you would have thought the
back of the hours. Yep. I'll do that and give him $1 tip.
Awesome. Wow. Thank you.
Dude. Two drinks. $1 a piece. It'll be cheap.
$2.
Oh my god. I should have cleaned those glasses better, sir. I'm so sorry.
You know, I'm sure we'll be ordering more again.
Okay. And you...
I can just start a tab. Sorry, go ahead.
Craig doesn't drink, so Craig doesn't know how this works.
Okay, sorry.
Come on, I've seen you drink for show.
Yeah, that's about it.
You roll your perception and intelligence.
That is 17.
Yes, you actually see your friend who you talked to earlier.
Boo, hey!
Oh, hi!
Are you
She gets off
this?
The man that she is working with, turns, blows him a kiss, and then starts walking over towards you.
Sugar, come here! Say hi!
He gives you a big hug. It has been months since you've seen her.
It probably has.
Yeah. Oh my god, you came!
Of course I came!
So, I got the picture. Thanks for that, I think that was someone from Friday.
I wouldn't be surprised. Her mother said she was supposed to be here with June.
But I've seen June here since Friday. I haven't seen this one since Friday.
It's kind of what we're worried about.
I haven't seen June yet tonight, though.
Okay.
Do you want me to just signal you as soon as...
Sure.
Okay, because she usually slips in the back entrance.
Gotcha.
But it'll be kind of hard to stay covert.
We can put on a show.
Man. You still can pull that off whenever you want to, can't you?
Oh, wow. I really do.
All right, I'll let you know.
Sounds good. How are tips doing tonight?
Yeah, I just started, so I'm like, you know, 70, 80. Not bad.
I was going to say, if you ever want a little hand, let me know.
Are you going to ask for Eagle's share? Because, you know.
No.
Oh,
I'm
okay.
Off the game. Oh. I'm doing this as a favor.
I really appreciate that. Because, you know, it really fulfills some of my client's specific needs. So.
I could imagine.
Oh, my goodness.
You would not, like, I understand. I get it.
And she goes back to the man who's now starting to get that impatient face going.
And I blow him a little kiss.
He comes back with your drinks.
Here you go, G&T.
Thanks. I think a healthy swing.
All right, excellent. Was that one of your friends?
Yeah.
Excellent. Is she going to be joining us?
Not in the same way you think.
She's
a little busy right now.
Yep, I can see that. You know, fine.
You're starting to get a little flush in the face, actually.
Yeah.
She's very talented, though.
Well, that's good to know.
Mm-hmm. Both of you excellent. Roll your perception plus intelligence, minus 4.
Perception, our perception bonus down here, like, or the perception score?
It's your perception plus your, if you have a bonus to it, that would apply,
okay.
If it's
okay.
For sight specifically.
Gotcha, okay.
Mm-hmm. 20? Oh, minus 4, sorry, 16.
16, okay.
16, 21, also 20. No, yes, 20.
Minus the
4?
Yep.
Wow.
No.
Did you? Okay.
Hold on. Yeah.
20
okay,
initially,
hold on.
Or did you subtract 4 and 16, still get 20?
16, 21.
Numbers are hard.
17.
There we go.
Welcome to adults doing basic math.
Yes.
It happens every week.
Uh-huh.
I was an engineering major. You can see why I'm not.
You guys do happen to notice a face who's trying to blend into the crowd.
Okay.
Can we decipher if it's like a standard awkward creeper or if it's like a fangy creeper?
You'd have to get closer to really tell the difference on that.
Okay. Man, woman?
Man.
Okay.
Alright. I'm gonna go powder my nose real quick. I'll be right back.
Alright. I'll guard your drink.
I head to the bathroom to alter my attire.
I'm assuming you're defaulting to your influencing mode.
Quite.
Okay.
This was a thing I used to do in the kid. Around the time in the 90s, we called it bimboing. We would take our shirts, tuck them in, and so it would just be like the top part, and then like a really low V. I'm doing that, and then I'm kind of like rolling the skirt slightly so it's a little bit higher, but still not like, oh, she totally just rolled up her skirt.
That modification will give you a +2.
Okay.
to your influence, specifically in seduction.
Cool.
I'm guessing that's what you were going for.
I was trying to blend in, yes. Look like one of the girls.
Okay.
And I go up to the strange guy who's trying to, like, act chill.
So, Craig, look at what that was.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a one.
Yeah.
That was his willpower.
I'm damn good.
He kind of does a little bit of a jaw drop as you walk toward him, and he goes, sorry.
I saddle up next to him because, you know, you want to be noticed, but not actually so needy that you actually act like you want to be noticed.
Hi.
Hello there. How's it going, sugar?
Good.
So what brings you in?
Did you want to get a room? He looks at you in a way that gives a signal he's not coming on to you.
Mm-hmm.
He's asking if you want to leave the public floor.
Let's get to know each other.
Okay.
I signal to you with like a hand gesture as we walk past.
Okay.
And upstairs, you know, they're the white rooms. That's what, just a nice contrast there. And there's 17 of them, five of which are occupied right now, which, I mean, a Monday night, pretty easy.
Yeah.
So you take one of the rooms, I assume, and leave them in?
Yep.
Okay. I'm just here because my boss said to look up some information on a missing girl.
Oh, you're the cop. You know you really do need to blend in a little more.
I was trying. This is my first undercover assignment.
I get that, honey.
A single man. Jesus. How am I supposed to focus on the job at hand? I mean, my God.
Oh, sugar. They're used to being your job in hand.
What?
Look, a couple of pointers. First of all, body language right there. Uh-huh. All wrong.
Oh.
Relax. Kind of spread yourself out a little.
Oh. Okay, so, okay.
Have a drink in hand. Kind of leave it loose.
Okay, kay. I'm loose. I'm...
Okay.
I'm here. I'm...
No, act like you've had sex with a girl before.
I have.
But you're not acting like it.
It's been a while. But you know what? I can get... I Do you know anything about... okay, her name's... Dana?
Dana Youngberg.
Do you know about Dana Youngberg? Did you see her?
Honey, no. I'm with Robert.
Oh, yeah, Carmichael.
Yeah.
Okay. So, why'd you guys ask us to come look into this for you if you're just gonna come here undercover yourself?
We're trying to do things by the book. Getting the cops involved is the number one help because you guys and Boys in Blue do help quite a bit.
Roll that.
Influence?
If you mean it, influence and intelligence. Okay. If you're trying to make him better at his job... for your own selfish means, crime and intelligence?
I actually meant that somewhat sincerely.
Okay.
I'm trying to give him a pep talk, but yes. At the same time, like, tell the truth.
Okay.
I do have a code of ethics.
Right.
Ooh, that's actually not bad.
That is really good, actually.
That is. 24.
Right.
Yes.
I would like to... Are the white rooms...
They're up away from the main floor.
Right. Are they roped off?
They're actually enclosed rooms up the stairs. What you have the main floor there, and yes, you would need to be escorted by a girl to get up there.
Gotcha. Okay.
Mm-hmm. I'm sorry I didn't have that interaction. The bouncer knew you at the front of the white room stairs.
Who doesn't? Right. Right. I get everyone in this stair.
Right. While this is happening, I'll give them a little bit of time, go up to the bouncer, and say, could you go and ask that last girl, I was with her, can you ask her if she's maybe looking for a third?
Hey.
Whoa.
Hey.
Oh.
She'd have given me the signal if she went for a third.
Just please ask, and I will pull out some.
You had to know what you're getting into, man. She's a professional.
I will pull out a 20.
Oh my god! I am worth more than a 20. Good stuff.
I'm asking him to go do something.
Yeah, I know. I'm just saying. Like, to you.
I don't need anyone charging these stairs and getting all jealous rampage on me. If she needs a third, she'll send down a wire for the third.
Alright. Okay.
Now just put that back in your wallet.
Okay.
Don't be the green-eyed monster. Just go ahead and have a seat. She'll be with you next. I'm sure. You came in with her, man. You've got her by the end of the night.
That is true. Okay. I will go back and sit back. I had her drink with me the whole time.
You got so jealous. I'm so flattered.
I want to be up there listening to this conversation.
Oh. Unrequited bullshit.
That's a great drawback, isn't it? Okay, after a nice little bit of pep talk and coaching, mm-hmm. Oh my god, this guy's got it down now.
Great.
Thank you.
Not a problem. Now, here's what I need you to do for me.
Yes.
I need you to mess up your shirt a little bit.
Okay. Untuck here and then half tuck here.
I would probably misdo your buttons.
Okay, yeah, unmiss a line. Okay, yeah, that's good. That looks great, actually.
Okay, now one more thing. A quick touch up my lipstick, grab his collar. There you go. Now, just walk out of here with a big old grin on your face, a little dazed look
that's
in your eyes.
That's the closest I've had to a kiss in 3 years. Wow.
Trust me, you're not the only one who's counting.
And you see him exit looking like he just got through a sex tornado.
Yeah.
It's awesome. Like, wow.
Yeah.
I love this place. The bouncer gives a nod to him, lets him walk on down. And after the, appropriate amount of time, you exit as well.
High five, bouncer.
Up high and then on the backside.
I go, see you, sweetie. And I walk back to you.
Here's your drink.
Thank you. I'm kind of thirsty. Another good healthy dose.
Yeah. Get any good information?
Yeah, that's your undercover boy.
That's... What was his... Junkins?
Yeah.
Oh, that's a weird name.
Yeah, well...
Do you know anything?
He's a little green.
Oh, this is a great place for green cops.
I mean, look, he's doing just fine now.
And yes, he actually does seem like he's just a young guy who's enjoying his time here at the bar. No more of that nervous energy. He just seems really relaxed and loose.
How much of that was you and how much of that was natural talent?
In what sense? Because I have natural talent.
Well, there is that, but he did not look like that when he went up there.
Nobody does.
Touché. Okay.
Why?
Well,
are you jealous?
No, but, like, he might actually be able to pull this off now.
You're welcome.
Cheers.
All right. As you two continue your drink,
Watching.
Your friend...
I believe our friend June is here.
Ooh, fantastic.
If you guys want to roll perception, go ahead.
Might as well.
You're going to be doing this with a plus... 5.
Ooh.
Oh, really?
This is
visual? Because you were just signaled that June was in, and gesture in the general area she's going to be entering, so.
20.
19.
Yeah, there is this teen girl who is kind of slipping in behind where you would normally see, like, the dancer's exit or the talent exit, but she's walking in from that door, dressed kind of like she's ready for the scene, but not full blown. Like, she's definitely not here to have fun. Right now, she's here on a mission.
Okay.
And she starts scanning the bar.
Gotcha.
As she's walking.
Gotcha.
Don't move. Just act natural.
Yep. Do we see any young girls around?
Actually,
someone that
no.
She might... Oh, okay, well, that's good.
She is the only one who is clearly a little out of place in this bar.
Gotcha.
So far, you don't see any telltale signs of a vampire hang, and when you check your watch, it's like, oh, the dark has just fallen.
Gotcha.
So that makes sense.
Mm-hmm. Right.
She's scouting.
Right. Well, how do we want to play this?
Let's keep an eye. We don't want to spook her.
That's good.
Okay.
Does your friend need any help with anything over there? Is she good?
Oh, she's on her way up to the white room now.
Okay. Fantastic.
I give her two thumbs up and click.
As you're trying to casually observe, since you're not doing it as directly, but you're still watching her, I'm not going to make you roll. She's actually talking actively with the bartender now, and the conversation seems to be getting a little heated.
Do you need a refresher on that drink?
I do now.
Sweet. Me too. And I go back up to
roll
the bar.
Roll that constitution double for me.
That's probably wise.
20!
Nice!
I can hold my liquor.
Constitution double. Let's see. I want to succeed at this, so I'm going to spend a drama point.
Seriously?
Yep. I want to do this real good. So I'm going to spend a drama point to add 10 to this.
Yep.
Freshman.
So, 16. So now it's plus 16. And of course, now I roll well. So 7 plus 16 is 23.
Oh, yeah. That didn't faze you at all.
Good. And back up to the bar.
And as you get closer, you hear very clearly, but I know that you're not her father. I'm just asking, did you see her? And the bartender just kind of shrugs and goes, yeah, just I got customers to help. And goes over to you. Oh, another one, sir.
We're going to change these to an old-fashioned and whiskey.
Oh, yes, sir. Coming right up.
Excellent. Thank you.
He gets out the bar rig, starts polishing up another glass.
Fantastic.
This one is a lot more vigorous.
Okay.
No spit this time.
Oh, good.
He's going to prepare the drinks.
Okay.
June is like... God damn it.
Everything okay?
You want perv?
You just seem upset, and I've got him, you know, he's... I think he's going to break those glasses cleaning him that hard, so...
You're trying for an icebreaker.
Yep.
Okay, that influence plus intelligence.
Yay!
Social characters are fun to make roles.
It's a 10!
You know what? It's a dry smile. Because that was still a success.
Well, good.
Adequate.
Thank God.
A lot of success.
Thank God.
I'd be amazed if you didn't just polish those glasses completely out. You know, just scrub an air eventually.
Well, he spit in this one, so, I mean, it's better than nothing.
Have you drank out of that?
You know, it was pretty strong, so I'm hoping it killed everything.
You are a freak, aren't you? A
little bit, yeah. Yeah.
Huh. What's your name?
My name's Rob.
Rob.
I am casually observing
June,
this.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. Are you sure everything's okay?
No.
Okay.
I had a friend who came into town, and she's supposed to stay at my place for the weekend, and went here, and she's just, you know, the guy she went with, I wonder if she just crashed with him.
She hasn't called? She hasn't...
No.
Oh.
You know, at first I was like, oh, good, go for it, girlfriend, you know. But now I'm starting to get worried, because, you know, she was just supposed to stay through the weekend, and if she's still here, I don't know. Hope she's okay.
You know, I've got a couple of friends here. They're pretty well connected. We could ask around.
I got friends here.
Okay.
They're going to be a little bit, though.
Okay. Well, I mean, I can certainly spread a little bit of word. What's her name?
Yeah, that they're kind of that, crossing a line.
Yeah,
here.
That's pretty forward. I understand. Yeah, I get it.
Do you
want to
try
fine.
And roll an influence at a minus three?
Sure.
Because you're still trying.
I am trying.
Yeah, and your conversation actually isn't going that badly.
Hey, okay. Minus three, you said?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so seven... Okay. 7 plus 1 is 8, plus what major ability score modifier? Intelligence?
That's going to be intelligence.
Okay, so what was it? 8 plus 5.
13. Minus 3, so
10. No, I already did that.
Oh.
So,
yeah.
At a 13.
I subtracted the 3 from my influence. Yep.
You're not a cop, are you?
No.
Dana.
Dana.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Dana.
Yeah.
Well, I can ask Jeez. Around.
She's, you know, just alone in the city, and she was just looking to kind of explore her options, you know, kind of like I did.
Well, yeah, I mean, going home with
She was my best friend in junior high, you know that?
Really?
Just in junior high?
Well, you know, left. Kind of did my own thing a little bit after that.
Gotcha. Yeah.
School wasn't my thing.
Ah, yeah. No, I understand that.
But yeah, the guys that I'm with, I mean, I think she would really like them, and that's why I introduced her to them.
So you know the guy she went home with?
No.
Oh.
No.
Total stranger.
Well. He's a friend of the guy that I'm kind of seeing right now. So figured he's got to be a good guy.
Does he? Have you talked to that guy? The guy you're kind of seeing.
I didn't talk to him because we're just having fun this weekend. It's not a big deal until you know Monday rolls around and suddenly I still haven't heard from her. Because what the hell could that mean? You know.
Right. I get it.
It's not a really good way to do. Hey.
Mm-hmm.
You know what you could do?
What?
Could you pretend to be a cop? I just want to see what if he's going to get, like, defensive. And then I can ask a question of him and, you know, yeah, can you do that for me? That'd be really nice if you did.
Is he a big guy?
Oh, like, he's a big, mean guy.
Oh. You know, we might be
able to... She is definitely sizing you up to be right. Our new sugar daddy.
Right. We could probably find a bigger, scarier person than me. To do that.
It's all right.
Yeah,
it's all right. You couldn't take him anyway. I understand.
No, that's probably true. Yeah. Okay,
you know, you made me laugh, though. Thank you for that.
Well, you know, gotta get by somehow.
The drinks are now back.
Thank you. I will pay for them.
Tip.
Okay.
Yep, tip. Tip included.
Always tip.
Yep.
Oh, my goodness. This is amazing. Twice in a row. What? Did you want to start a tab?
You know, that's probably smart. Yeah, let's awesome. Do that. And, you know, do you want something?
June actually is gone.
Oh.
Well, she took off shortly after the drinks came.
Oh.
Yep.
Okay.
Well. Kind of oddly fast.
Right.
Like, go ahead and do that knowledge occult. Do you have any occult?
I told you, no.
Okay.
But I have knowledge.
Roll that knowledge.
And I do know fangers. Because of, you know, being in the business.
Mm-hmm.
11.
She is definitely more spry, even more so than you'd expect like a teenage girl to be, because she, as soon as he turned head, was slinked right around and back into a corner, and you know that dark corner.
Great.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, I will grab the drinks and take them back.
It looks the VIP area.
Yep.
And that's exactly what they tell their customers in the main area.
Yeah. Here's your old-fashioned.
Okay.
So that was June.
She seems nice.
Oh, she's something. So she admits that Dana was with her on Friday night.
Okay.
And says that Dana went home with someone who she knew through the guy she's sort of seeing.
So she's dating a fanger.
Seems that way.
Kay.
She seems worried, but she bolted pretty fast, and she wanted me to pretend to be a police officer confront the guy she's kind of seeing.
You said yes, right?
I said we could probably find someone better suited to do it.
Oh, I know.
I'm seeing the error of my ways, yes.
Look, I mean, I get it. He probably is stronger, but...
She said he was big and scary.
You're big and scary, too.
Not against vampires, though.
Okay.
Okay.
True. But you got me.
That's true. And maybe we could get Junkins in on this.
Do you want me to take Junkins upstairs again?
Did you see where she went? I mean, she bolted.
VIP.
That VIP?
Yes. The VAMP.
Oh. Great.
Yes, she bolted faster than normal.
That would make sense. Okay. Yeah. Cool. So this seems like a trap.
Mm.